Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. Loretta Swit. Charles Nelson Reilly. Marianne Mobley. Richard Dawson. And Kay Ballard. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rivers.
Hello there. Thank you. Okay. What do you say we say hello to these beautiful and talented people? Hello, beautiful and talented people.
Hello.
No, you.
Oh, hello. 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 Hello there.
You're the beautiful and talented ones. Hello there.
You look marvelous.
Yeah, you don't look so bad yourself. Well, no, we've got to do this other show here first. Listen, what are you up to? Are you summer stocking or doing any of that?
Yes, my husband, Gary Collins, and I are going out to do cactus flower.
Oh, where will you be doing that? At various parts of the country?
Yes, for Frank Kinley primarily.
Oh, yes.
Frank? Right.
It's yes. John Kinley,
John
isn't it?
Kinley.
No, it's Frank, his brother.
Frank, his brother.
Right.
And what town is that in?
I was afraid you were going to ask that because I think it's somewhere in Nebraska.
Well, your
fans... I know I'm going there in mid-August.
Your fans will be looking forward to seeing you,
I hope they will come and see us. We'll need a lot of support.
Thank you for being here with us today. Shall we begin, folks?
Okay.
Okay, let's begin by saying hello and greeting our current champion, Dr. Bill Lally. Hello, Bill. When time ran out last time, you had just won a game, and you were about to have a go at the supermatch. You've already won $6,900, three games in a row. And are you all set for the supermatch?
Ready to go.
All right, I'll get you around here, and we'll have a go at that right after this. Bill Lally here is going to have a go at the supermatch, see if you can go up to the $5,000. Are you ready, Bill?
All set.
All right, you've been here before, you know how it goes. We polled a previous studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Street, or Blank Street. The answer given most often by that studio audience is worth $500 if you can match it. The second most frequent answer, $250, and the third, $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help you. Let's choose them now, one at a time, and get their responses.
I'll go with Old Faithful Bert, first of all.
Bert Convy?
Old Blank Faithful?
Street, yeah.
To make that young faithful?
Yeah. Your answers have been good. He's won money with you.
Gee, there's a lot of possibilities there. Let's say 42nd Street.
42nd Street is
bad.
His answer.
Wrong, huh? Sorry, gang.
The audience is not too fond of that, but it's our game here. All right, go.
Marianne?
My first thought is Backstreet.
Backstreet.
Right. No?
All right, that's your answer. Backstreet, that's it, folks. Okay, one more celebrity, Bill.
Richard?
Girl, I had the pleasure of playing with several times, Della Street from the Perry Mason Show.
Della Street.
Who lives on a back street just behind 42nd Street.
Right.
Now, don't get hostile. These are all true stories.
That's right.
Della Street.
Your celebrities are giving you 42nd Street, Back Street, and Della Street.
Oh, could I change mine? Is it too late?
I think it's too late to change.
Think
can't
this
change.
Is good.
Too
Shut
late.
Up.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Okay, fine.
Yeah.
Now, you may choose one of those three or give us one of your own, but now we must call for your answer.
I'm going to be a little independent this time. I'm going to go for Sesame Street.
Oh. Sesame Street. What are you saying there? Why didn't we think of that?
Of course, you're right, Doc.
He didn't want to be obvious.
They've got a lot of confidence in your answer, and let's see how it works out. We are looking for his answer, Sesame Street. Let's find out how that audience reacted. May we see the $100 response? One-Way Street. Not a bad answer.
I work with her, too.
We're still looking for Sesame Street. May we see the $250 response? Main Street. Another good one. You had that one, too, there. All right, Bill, third and last chance. Looking for Sesame Street. May we see the $500 response? Sesame Street it is. You got it. Okay. Well, that's a champ for you. He did it again. So, he's got the $500. You've won the audience match part of it. And now you're going to go head-to-head with one celebrity and you'll be going for $5,000. Yeah. Are you ready?
I'll never be ready for that, but I'm going to go for the third time around as a charm with Bert, all right?
All right, Bert Convy, you get ready to write. Bill, you face me again. And now, I'll get the question, and this is it. Write your answer to this, Bert. Fire blank. Fire blank. All right, Bert has finished writing. Now, Bill, we'll call for your response. How do you fill in that blank? Fire?
Hydrant.
Fire hydrant is what he says. Okay, Bert, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
I'm in the neighborhood. I said fire chief.
Fire chief. Yeah. I guess there were a number of good possibilities.
Yeah, fire insurance.
Yeah.
Yeah, fire break. Sorry, Doc.
You guys are almost on the same track there. Well, listen, you've won the additional $500, and that makes your total now $7,400. And you're going to meet another player. So let's bring that player out right now. Hello there. Let's all greet and say hello to Elizabeth Woothridge. All right, Bill, you want to have a seat there? There's Elizabeth, your challenger, Bill. You want to say hello to each other there and wish each other well? I know you do that because you're both lovely people. Did I say your name correctly?
Yes.
Good. Woothridge. All right. You want to tell us more about yourself other than your name?
I'm a history student at UCLA, and I work part-time, and that's about all.
Okay. You know how we do this? We're going to ask you questions, you and Bill, and you'll try to answer them in a way that'll match the celebrities. You'll have two chances. The one who's done that the most times at the end of the second round wins, gets $100, and the chance to go for $5,000 as he just did. Okay, challenger, would you please make a selection?
A.
A is what she says. Everybody plays because this is a brand new game. Are you ready for us?
Yes.
Okay. Mary said, if my family ever found out I was a blank, they'd have a fit.
Ever found out I was a blank? A blank.
I should have said, Mary said, if my family ever found out I was a blank, they'd have a fit. Think about it.
I am thinking about it. I'm trying to figure out what to write.
Mary said, if my family ever found out I was a blank, I'd have a fit. Wait a minute. They're not finished yet. The lower tier is finished. Bert is finished. Loretta's now finished. And we're waiting for the concert master.
Okay.
Now he is finished. So, Elizabeth, would you give us your response, please?
A pregnant lady.
Ever found out I was a pregnant lady, they'd have a fit. Okay, that's her answer.
Yes.
All right. Bert, may we see your answer,
yes,
please?
Yes, they'd also be upset if she was a pregnant hippie, is what I said.
A hippie. Hippie. All right, pregnant lady is her answer. Loretta, what's yours?
I misunderstood the whole question.
You did?
See, I had this woman married to this family with children and a husband, and they would be very upset if they found out she was a guru.
A guru. Okay. All right.
Wonderful to see you.
Good night, Gracie.
Charles, what do you say?
Pregnant like ladies, Loretta, right? She was a high school dropout.
High school dropout. All right. Got some very imaginative answers from the upper tier. Let's see what happens here.
Well, I couldn't think of anything terribly interesting that I could say, so I said bubble dancer.
A bubble dancer. Would you like to demonstrate? No. Okay, Richard.
What is that up there?
A bubble dancer?
Bubble dancer, right.
I know it's an antiquated term.
It certainly is.
Now, wait a minute.
Hold
you
on
have
now.
Something interesting?
What do you hear from Lawrence Welk? If that young lady did turn out to be a pregnant lady, she might have a fur coat, which might be a perfect fit, but she wouldn't be able to button it up. So I put actress.
Actress.
With all child.
Right. Kay, what do you say?
I went all the way, a hooker.
A hooker. Is that, was that your answer, audience? Yeah. Actress, Johnny, would you get the other audience, please? Okay. Now let's go to Bill's end of this round. Everybody plays, and this is it. Kay said to Loretta.
That's funny,
but she
right?
She doesn't talk to me.
Kay said to Loretta, whenever John is tense, I give him a blank.
That's funny. She said that to me, too.
Okay. Ready over there? Ready over here? No, we get Bill's answer. Kay said to Loretta, whenever John is tense, I give him a...
Now I know what I would like when if I'm tense, and that would be a massage.
A massage?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that may happen up here. You never know. Bert, what do you say?
Yes, I agree with him. I call it a rub down, but I believe it's the same. Is it not?
Massage and rub down is a match. Okay, there's one for you. Loretta?
Doctor. Rub down.
Rub down it is. Okay, so there's two for the doctor. Charles?
I was going to say hooker, but I changed it to pill.
Give him the pill. That's a hooker of whiskey. Yeah, I see.
Yes,
okay. Massage is his answer. Mary Ann,
I was going to say pill, but then I changed it to massage.
So there's another match. Now, Mr.
Kay
Dawson.
Kay said to Loretta, whenever John's tense, I give him a pill.
Pill.
And then Loretta said, you idiot, you're supposed to take that.
Oh.
Let his mother work.
Now I'm going to really tell you what Kay said.
What did Kay say?
Kay says that the dentist must at least give this girl some free dental work because she is so far behind. A massage.
You got the upside down massage here. Okay, so you did well with that. Bill, it's four celebrity matches for you, and we'll go to round two right after this. Okay, here we are. We're going to start round two, and Elizabeth, I remind you, as we start round two, the score is 4-0 in favor of our champion here, Bill Lolly. And as we ask you to make a selection, you must match four celebrities to stay in the running. Would you make a selection?
B.
B is what she wants. Okay, everyone participates. This is it. Dear Miss Lonely Hearts, my parents won't let my boyfriend in the house because he refuses to blank. Everybody's writing down here. Start writing up there. Dear Miss Lonely Hearts, my parents won't let my boyfriend in the house because he refuses to...
Wait a minute.
Oh, John
refuses to wait a minute.
Oh,
okay.
God.
Now, let's get Elizabeth's answer and see what it is. He refuses to... Now, think about it there. Here's his boyfriend. And the parents said, don't bring that boy in this house because...
Until...
Can you think of anything at all?
No. Come on, Elizabeth.
What did your mother used to say?
She didn't have boyfriends like that.
You're drawing a blank on this,
yes,
and that happens sometimes.
Total blank.
You must come up with an answer before the buzzer sounds, or we'll just have to...
Shake hands?
Okay. All right, she came up with the answer, shake hands, just as the buzzer sounded. So that'll be her answer. You must match four celebrities to stay in the running. Let's see if it happens. Bert?
Yes, I said until he cut his hair.
Cut his hair. Yeah. Audience likes that answer. Seems like it's a reasonable response. Loretta?
Oh, I made her parents a little more ambitious. And until he proposed, he wasn't going to be allowed to
propose
the house anymore.
Okay.
Or shave.
So that does not match shake hands. So therefore, Bill Lolly has won his fourth game. Congratulations, Bill. Want to come around, Bill? And stand in the usual spot there. Well, Elizabeth, you're a charming lady. This happens sometimes in this game. I've played it a lot myself. I know occasionally you went blank, just as you
just
did there.
Zap.
And it was the wrong time to you. I'm sorry for you. We've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being on Match Game 73.
Okay. What would you like to say?
I don't know. I'm pretty speechless right now.
Well, you're up to $7,400 at the moment, and here we go again with the super match. Are you ready?
All set.
All right. We polled a previous studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Joe Blank. And the answer they gave most often is worth $500, and then $250 and $100. And let's see how you're going to do with this now. Remember, you're going to choose three celebrities one at a time and get their responses.
Well, one of them has to be Bert, of course.
All right, Bert, Joe Blank.
Well, a current one, contemporary, let's go for Joe Namath.
Joe Namath. All right. Another celebrity, Bill?
How about Richard?
Brown Bomber, Joe Louis.
Joe Louis. Okay. The boxer. Okay.
Okay.
Joe DiMaggio.
Okay. Three famous Joes there. You got Namath, Joe Louis, and Joe DiMaggio. You can choose one of those or give one of your own if you like. But now's the time for the answer.
Well, I've always been a fan of that wonderful boxer. I'm going to have to go with Joe Louis.
Joe Louis. Okay, we're looking for Joe Louis. May we see the $100 response? Joe Palooka. There's another boxer. You're right. Not the one we're looking for, though. We're looking for Joe Louis. May we see the $250 response? Joe Namath is up there. That's the one that Bert gave you. Okay, third and last chance. Looking for Joe Louis, the $500 response. Joe Blow. It's a...
When did you poll this dumb audience?
I don't know. A week or two ago, something like that.
How could they leave out Joe DiMaggio? What a crazed...
I don't
crazed...
know. I don't know. But Joe Blow is a thing for a non-entity, you know. That's what it is. Okay, now you're up to $7,500. You're going to meet another challenger and play another game. And we'll get to that right after we get to this. We're ready to start another game. Let's do that by welcoming a new player. Here is Faith Bitterolf. Hi, Faith. You know Bill?
Yes, I know Bill.
Okay. Let's have Faith tell us a little bit about herself.
Well, I'm married and have three children, and I live in the friendliest neighborhood in Temple City.
Okay. Nice to have you here. You know how we play here?
Yes, I'm afraid so. I've been watching him.
Okay. I'll push the button here and reveal the questions there for the first round, and the challenger makes the first selection, if you would, Faith.
I'll start off with A.
A is what she wants. Here it is. New game. Everybody plays. These must be exact matches when we get to it. Name a slang word for drunk. Name a slang word for drunk. For drunk. Okay, all finished over there.
I love him. He's acting like he's having a hard time of thinking.
Sometimes he does.
Just ask me.
Are you allowed to ask clarifying questions?
Well, I can just repeat it for you. Name a slang word for drunk.
Okay, for drunk.
Yeah.
Smashed.
Smashed. All right. Let's see what happens up here. Smashed is her answer. Bert, may we see yours?
I think she matched everyone in the audience. I said plastered.
Plastered is another slang word for drunk, but not matching smashed. Loretta.
We all know you don't drink. That's why you don't know that it's smashed.
Smashed is one match for you there, okay?
I was going to hide the S, and, but I thought
Charles, I know you never touched the stuff, but show us your card.
I'm acting. I went with stoned.
Stoned. Oh, I see. Okay. Let's come down here to Mary Ann.
Everyone knows it's smashed.
Smashed it is. Another match for you, Faith. Okay, slang word for drunk.
We'd like to point out that Charles doesn't drink as much now. We slowed him down. We bent his funnel.
All right.
I put booze.
Booze. Okay.
Excuse me. No need for that, buddy.
What? Drunk, smashed.
Smashed.
Smashed it is. So you got another one. Okay. Now you've got half the celebrities there. Let's see how Bill does with his half here. Raquel.
Yes.
Blanked with every man at the party. Raquel blanked with every man at the party. Okay, do it as quickly as you can, if you please. You finished? All right. Okay. Let's hear it, Bill. Raquel?
I think she danced.
Danced with every man at the party? Bert Convy, what do you say, Raquel?
She could have danced all night.
All right, there's one for you. And Loretta?
She could have danced.
There's another one for you.
I thought she flirted with
everyone. Flirted with everyone at the party. And Marianne?
Oh, everyone knows she's very prim and proper and only shook hands with everybody.
Shook hands with everyone at the party.
I couldn't get near enough to dance with her, so she flirted with me.
I see. All right, Jay Ballard, dance is what he's looking for, and dance is what you give him. So, the score is tied 3-3, and we'll come back to these two people right after this. We have to say goodbye to Faith and Bill until next time. Score is tied 3-3. We'll pick it up with round two when we meet again. Thank you. And thank you. You were splendid as usual. You're a lovely
bunch. Forget about me. I'm no good for you.
Oh, yes, you are. Gene Rayburn saying so long to Match Game 73.
Today's consolation prizes are Charm Glow Wet, the completely portable gas grill that goes anywhere. Instant flame without starter fluids or charcoal. Charm Glow products of Antioch, Illinois. And a supply of You Know Drip Good Humor, rich, creamy tasting ice cream specially made to melt slow, drip less. Doesn't mess you up. That's good humor. And a supply of Adolph's Instant Meat Tenderizer helps make meat tender, juicy, and delicious. Any cut of meat can taste even better with Adolph's, the original meat tenderizer. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.